Hello students, today we are going to see types of wires and cables. Let us see the difference between a wire and a cable. Okay, so wire and cable are two terms that are used in electrical as well as communication fields. Basically, a wire is a single conductor strand. Strand is nothing but one single conductor like this. This is one strand. Are group of conductor strands. So if there are group of strands, so that this will be, this is group of strands. Okay, so a wire can be a single conductor strand or group of conductor strands, where strands are made of copper or aluminium. So we know that most of the domestic house wire is made of copper are aluminium. So because they are having high conductive property, we are going to use copper or aluminium in the case of conductors. Okay, whereas cable is two or more insulated wires wrapped in one jacket. That means cable is two or more insulated wires. That means, so let us see, so this is one strand, one conductor. Okay, so this conductor will be wrapped in a insulation, with a insulation. So let us say this is insulation. Okay, and let us consider another conductor with insulation. This is second conductor with having insulation on the conductor. So this is insulation, and these two conductors which are insulated will be wrapped in one jacket. That means, so let me take this one here. So these two are bundled in a one single outer cover. This is called cable here. Okay, so this is the difference between wire and a cable. Multiple conductors that have no insulation around would be classified as a single conductor. Here you can see multiple conductors without an insulation around them will be considered as a single conductor. Okay, now let us see the types of wires here. Okay, so here we have four types of wires, basically single strand, multi strand, ACSR, AAAC. We are going to see each and every one. First one is single strand wire. Here you can see a single aluminium conductor is taken out here. Okay, so this is single conductor here. This single conductor. Okay, and we have an insulation around that single conductor. So this is nothing but single strand. This one single conductor is called a strand. If we have multiple strands, that conductor will be called as multi-strand. Here you can see this 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four strands, that's why it is called multi-strand conductor. So these are the types. Actually, multi-strand conductor is used for our domestic house wiring. Most of you have already seen this, right? So we will be having more than 18 strands in our domestic house wiring conductor, which is used to supply our lights and fans. Okay, so here the single strand wire also uses THHN wire, that is thermoplastic high heat resistant nylon coated, okay, wire. Though there are other variants, each wire is separate and multiple wires can be drawn together through a pipe easily. So this is what we are going to do in a house wiring, right? So we are going to keep some pipes through the walls and then we are going to place the conductors through the pipes. Okay, so this is nothing but conduit wiring. This type of wiring is called conduit wiring. Okay, which is one of the types of house wiring. Single strand wires are the most popular choice for layouts that use pipes to contain wires. Okay, single strand wires are used in a pipes and contain wires layouts. Okay, so this is about single strand. Now let us see multi strand wires. Okay, as I have already told you, this is multi strand wires. Multi-strand wiring is more flexible and less susceptible to cracking and metal fatigue than single-stranded conductors. Here you can see, for a single strand wire, if somewhere due to the mechanical stress on the conductor, it may broken, right? It may be broken, single strand. If in one place, if the wire is broken in one place, the entire circuit will be open circuited. Okay, coming to multi-strand wires, okay, these are very flexible and these are less susceptible to cracking and breaking. Okay, so that's why this is the advantages. Multi-strand wire is advantageous than single strand wire. This makes it the preferable solution for wiring that will need to bend without experiencing metal fatigue. So if we have a bend across a wall like this, okay, so our conductor has to pass through this bend without any mechanical damage. So if we use one single strand, it may break here. Okay, so this, if it is break, then there will be no supply beyond this point. So this is one disadvantage of single strand. So if you use multi-strand conductor instead of single strand, even if you lost one conductor, one strand, the remaining strands will give the supply to the load. So this is the advantage of multi-strand. Okay, the increased surface area of multi-stranded conductors decreases the amount of resistance that currents or signal passing through the wire will encounter. Here we have an expression for resistance that is equal to rho L by A. Okay, so where rho is the resistivity, okay, L is the length of conductor, where A is the area of cross section of conductor. Okay, if the area of cross section is more, what happens to the resistance? Because it is inversely proportional. If area of cross section is more, the resistance will be less. That's why multi-strand conductors will be having more area compared to single strand, which is advantageous. Okay. Okay. So as area of the multi-strand conductors is more than the single strand conductor. Okay. So the resistance offered by multi-strand conductors is less than resistance offered by single strand conductor. So this is one more advantage of multi-strand conductors. Okay. Now let us see the third type of conductor, that is ACSR. ACSR stands for aluminum conductor, steel reinforced. Okay, here you can clearly see a strand here. So this circular conductor, each conductor is called a strand here. Here you can see this is a multi-strand conductor, multi-strand and twisted like this, and here in the center you can see here, so you can see in the center there is a change in color. So this part is called reinforcement that is made up of steel here, okay, and the upper part is made up of aluminium. Okay, so this upper part, so this part here, these strands are made up of aluminium. Okay, so the upper layer strands are made up of aluminium, AL, whereas the lower layer, the center layer, is strands are made up of steel. So that's why the name aluminium conductors, steel reinforced. So why do we need to add the steel at the center of this conductor? Because we are going to keep the conductors between two poles like this. So let us assume these are two poles, electric poles. Okay, now we have to keep our conductor between these two poles here. Okay, so actually the conductor is supposed to be like this, but due to the tension in the wire, it may be like this. So this is called sag here. This is called sag. The position of conductor, actual it is to be here, but due to the tension of the conductor, it is bending like this. So this bend of conductor is called sag. So why it is happening? Because of low tension of the low tensile strength of the aluminium. So in order to reduce this, if you observe this, the conductor length is more in this case compared to in this case. That means we are having more conductor. We are using more conductor instead of less conductor. That's why the loss of material is very much higher in case of sag. So to reduce this sag effect, we are going to use steel material at the center of the aluminum conductor so that it will increase the tensile strength of the material. The tensile strength will be increased so that the conductor will be approximately in parallel with this line here. So there will be no problem of sag, so that we can save the material. Okay, so this is ACSR conductor. So this is what is used for transmission lines. Okay, so ACSR is used for transmission lines. Okay, the outer strands are high purity aluminium, chosen for good conductivity, low weight and low cost. The center strand is steel for additional strength to help support the weight of the conductor. Okay, so this is about ACSR conductor. Now let us see that fourth type of wire, that is AAAC, all aluminium alloy conductors. So you can understand that. So the conductor is having all aluminium conductors. Okay, but there is an alloy, that means mixture of two or three elements, metals. So here AAAC is a combination of aluminium, magnesium and silicon alloy. So the combination of these three metals will give us AAAC. Concentric lay standard aluminium alloy AAAC are made out of high strength aluminium, magnesium, silicon alloy. These conductors are designed to get better strength to weight ratio, strength to weight ratio, and offer improved electrical properties when compared to ACSR. So in ACSR we are using steel reinforcement, right? So in order to avoid the steel, we are going for AAAC conductor, which is not a pure aluminium. It is alloy of aluminium, magnesium, silicon, which gives the same strength, tensile strength of ACSR conductor, so that we can eliminate steel material use here. Okay, so this is about AAAC. First we have single strand conductor, single strand. Second we have multi strand. Third we have ACSR. Fourth one here is AAAC connector. So these are the wires, types of wires here. Now let us see the types of cables. Okay, so the types of cables are classified as VIR insulated cable, CTSR, TRS cable, PVC cables, lead sheathed cables. So you might have known what is a cable is, right? You might have known what a cable is. Okay, here we have four types of cables: VIR insulated cable, CTS, TRS cable, PVC cable, lead sheathed cable. Okay, so let us see one by one. First one is VIR cables, vulcanized Indian rubber. VIR stands for vulcanized Indian rubber. Okay, you know vulcanization, right? Vulcanization of rubber is nothing but adding around 1 to 4% of silicon to the rubber to increase the strength. That is nothing but vulcanization, vulcanized Indian rubber. It consists of copper conductor covered with a insulation layer of vulcanized Indian rubber. Okay, here you can see. So this is the copper conductor on which VIR insulation is made to protect against corrosion from VIR. Okay, this is suitable for medium voltage supply only. Here you can see this part is called vulcanized Indian rubber. So this entire structure is called a cable. Okay, vulcanized Indian rubber cables are nothing but we are using VIR as insulation on a copper conductor. A cotton tape covering is provided over this insulation layer to protect the wire from moisture and to provide mechanical strength to the wire. So generally wires are used for overhead or transmission lines, overhead transmission line, whereas cables are used for underground transmission lines. That means these are kept in the ground to transmit the power from one area to another area. Okay, so wires are used for overhead transmission lines, cables are used for underground transmission line. This is very important point. Okay, so the application of wires is overhead transmission lines. Application of cables is underground transmission line. Okay, this is very important. So here we have a conductor on which VIR insulation is made. On top of that, a cotton tape covering is provided over this insulation layer to protect the wire from moisture and to provide mechanical strength of the wire. Okay, so here this is cotton tape here. You can see this is cotton tape here, this white one, white color one, which is covered, which covers our VIR insulation, which is placed on the conductor, copper conductor. Okay, so this is used for low or medium voltage, used in indoor wiring. Okay, the VIR cables are used in indoor wiring. Second type of cable is CTS or TRS wires. CTS stands for cab type sheath, or TRS stands for tough rubber sheath. Okay, this also consists of vulcanized rubber insulated conductor. So this one, first one is conductor here, second one is rubber insulation, third one is rubber sheath, fourth one is bedding. Until this is called bedding. Okay, so conductor is insulated with our rubber sheath, rubber material, and on top of which we are going to use rubber sheath. This is rubber sheath. Rubber sheath. Sheath is also one protection layer to protect our rubber insulation from moisture, external moisture. Where the fourth one is bedding, which protects the entire cable from mechanical damages. So this insulation layer is covered by a layer made of tough rubber or tough rubber sheath covering. This covering is very hard and protects the wire from moisture and provides mechanical strength. This is used for outdoor applications of voltage 250 to 440. Okay, where VIR wires cables are used for indoor applications. Coming to our CTS or TRS wires, these are used for outdoor applications. Now coming to the third type of cable, that is PVC cables. These are famous types of cables. Okay, you can see anywhere which has a electric application. These wires consist of conductor over which an insulation layer made up of polyvinyl chloride is used. So this is PVC material. PVC, this is insulation. So these are copper strands here. You can see the small strands. Okay, so on copper strands, to protect this copper strand, we have insulation on which we have one sheet here. This is called bedding or sarving. Okay, these wires cannot resist much heat and they have relatively low melting points. That means because of the closeness of the conductors, they can't resist more heat. So if the conductor is bare one, the heat generated by this conductor will be dissipated in the air. Because of this insulation and cable, the heat will not dissipate in the air. So these cables will be having less melting point. That means they will be melt for less temperature. Okay, so they aren't used in hot places, and also these wires are not used with heating applications. Okay, PVC wires are available in almost all colors. These are available in 250 to 440 volts ratings. Okay, so these are famously used for insulation. The last type of cable is called lead sheathed cables. These wires consist of vulcanized rubber insulated conductor over which lead sheath is provided. Here this is conductor here, this is copper conductor, and this is here rubber here, and on which we have lead sheath. So this is lead sheath. Okay, we have conductor, rubber, on which we have lead sheath. This is lead sheathed cables. Okay, so this lead sheath will give the mechanical strength to the wire and also protects from moisture. As lead is also a conductor for electricity, so lead covering is provided with earth wire. That means, so this, there is one concept called earthing. So this lead covering can be also be used as earth wire. That I'm going to discuss later. Okay, so these are available in 240 and 415 volts grade. Okay, so this is about wires and cables. We have four types of wires: single strand, multi strand, ACSR, AAAC. Conductor, multi strand has multiple strands. coming to cables, we have four types: VIR, CTS or TRS, PVC and lead sheathed cable. CTS is cap type sheath or tough rubber sheath, right? And lead sheathed cables are used for having the rating of 240 to 415 volts. So this is about wires and cables. Okay, thank you.